Okay, welcome back to the second half of the morning session for the last day of the IEC 2016. Next presentation will be about the Thai Mooc National Strategy for Lifelong Learning by Assistant Professor Anuchai, Teeraroungchaisri, who is currently the Associate Dean in Educational Innovation, Faculty of Pharmaceutical Sciences, Chulalongkorn University, and he is also the Deputy Director, Thailand Cyber University Project, Office of Higher Education Commission, Ministry of Education. Distinguished participants, ladies and gentlemen, please welcome Dr. Anuchai, Teeraroungchaisri.
Ladies and gentlemen, good morning and สวัสดีครับ. Thank you very much, Dr. Lachen, for introducing me. I am very pleased to present Thai Mooc in this conference, and also pleasure to present in English too. First of all, my outline of presentation may be similar to Professor Yamada outline without any talking or discuss before, but we have the same similar outline to present. I would like to start from the background or rationale of Thai Mooc and then proceed to the establishment of Thai Mooc and then the current situation and the system of the Thai Mooc. Let me elaborate more about the background and rationale of Thai Mooc. Maybe similar to other countries, that we have demand or need from the demand side from the student and also the supply side from the university. According to the statistic in 2012, we found that only 40% of students can have opportunity in university, and the rest 60% did not have any opportunity for university or higher education. So we leave out a lot of students. And also, every 15 years, Commission on Higher Education do a planning for 15 years long range plan, and the second 15 years long range plan, they found that higher education, especially university, should take care or responsible not only for the student, for the secondary student that entrance to the university, but also have to responsible to the working people in the industry, that we have more than 30 million people. Higher education should have some role to improve their skill, their knowledge, to raise the potential of the working people in the countries. That is the demand side. For the supply side, for the university side, up until now, we have 157 higher education institutes, including university, college, and other similar level of higher education institutes. This chart shows the statistic or demographic of the university. We have both public and private. We have 83 public and 74 private in higher education institute. But the competitiveness or potential to compete to other university in other country in the term of ranking system, we found that we still lag behind, or we still need to improve ourselves a lot to have potential to compete to other institutes. So Okay. From 157, we have only maybe 10 something university that appear on the ranking chart. So it's a wide range of university quality. Okay. Sorry. This is the situation of higher education from demand side and supply side. So how MOOC is the new way of providing education, how MOOC can accommodate or can address or can solve some problem in the higher education, and do Thailand ready for MOOC? As many professors present in this conference about MOOC, so I will skip what is MOOC, but in short, MOOC is the massive way of providing open online education. So mean that everyone in everywhere that can connect to internet, they will have opportunity to access the education. So when concerned about readiness to MOOC, we can divide the factor to consider into foundation factor, enabling factor. We should have good foundation factors, and then we should have good enabling factor to be readiness for Thai MOOC or for MOOC education. For the foundation, we should have a very fast, reliable network infrastructure. We should have a big portal of content, maybe in open educational resources or open courseware or any kind of digital content that ready to combine to become a big online course, and also the readiness of learner. And they should have accessible to internet. And then the enabling is the cooperation of the provider or the supply side, maybe the university, and also regulation and law should support the way to provide MOOC or online education. And also we should motivate teacher to participate in, to buy in, and there will be mediator to conduct the MOOC course to the student. And then we should address the difficulty or the problem of the higher education in the top of this chart. So I will show some readiness factor. As all of you will know that the structure of Ministry of Education in Thailand, we have five pillars, and especially we have three pillars that take care of the basic education, vocational education, and also the higher education. So this is three pillars that cover maybe the major portion of the learner in the formal education and also in non-formal education. And also this pillar, Office of Permanent Secretary, take care of the non-formal education. We have we continuing have a very long plan of ICT for education, and including the plan of ICT for education, we have at least three ministries that have a very major influence on the ICT for the country and for education. We have Ministry of ICT, we have Ministry of Education, and also Ministry of Science and Technology. And all of them have a master plan to take care and to develop the ICT for the country, including the education. I have some problem with with the clicker. Okay, this is the map show that the internet connection among, in the center is the UNINET. UNINET is an inter-university network connecting all university or public university in Thailand. Very strong, very fast internet. And also they have a strong and fast internet, reliable and fast internet to other network, including the international network. But not only the university, now UNINET become national education network. So UNINET will connect to the school also, secondary school. Sorry. Okay. This map shows that the UNINET connect to the major secondary school in all parts of Thailand. So mean that if we provide some online education via the UNINET, so it will reach to the university, also to the school, secondary school, major secondary school in the country. And from time to time, UNINET will expand to cover more school, including primary school also. So this infrastructure may be ready for providing some kind of education. And also, not only the public network, but also the private network. We will experience that now the private, we have many private companies to provide the internet service, and the service very good, better and better, and now faster and faster. So maybe no problem. As you may know that in Thailand we have 150 and plus some university, but we try to set up a network of university to strengthen among the university in the same region. So we have 9 region, and in each region we have the major university to become the hub university. So every policy from the Commission on Higher Education will deliver to the hub university, and they will conduct the cooperative activity among the member university in that region. This structure of network very strong and very benefit to when Commission on Higher Education want to deliver policy or run some new project or some new innovation, we run through the region network. So you can see we have 9 major university. So in the past, as you already know that Thailand Cyber University, we have a very long time that try to initiate or try to support the online ways of education or ICT education. Maybe up until now, it may be 11 years ago from 2008. So we have a lot of projects that create the readiness from time to time. We empowering the major university in the regional network, and then we try to support or try to cooperate with them to provide courseware, to encourage every university to share courseware. We have a big courseware portal. Maybe some of you have try and also utilize the content in the courseware portal. And also many projects that I will walk through very fast. This is the strategy of PCU. Okay. we have TCU open course where we have TCU group, as Professor Yamada mentioned, that TCU as a member in the group project, and now group will become the group 2.0, the new group that have new strategy, and we also expect to be the member of the new group system. Professor Yamada, he is the one who introduced group to Thailand CyberU. Group is the project that interconnect all content portal from each country, each individual country that have a content portal, interconnect together and let the user, let the student or teacher can search through. Mean that they just put a one keyword and they can search all major portal in the network, and they find the result from the major portal, similar to Google. But in this way, we found the course, not only the web page, but the course or the quality content from the major university or major portal of member of group. And also, we conduct knowledge management, knowledge sharing, such as this conference every yearly. And also we do training. This is the part activity. Okay, I will skip this time. This slide very fast, but not fast because the clicker not work. Okay, we have a MOU to major university. We have group project. Now, I would like to present more about Thai Mooc. At the first time, 2014-15, Thai Mooc established under Thailand Cyber University project under the Commission on Higher Education. But as all of you will know that the current government run the policy about digital economy. And under digital economy, they have five pillars. Hard infrastructure, soft infrastructure, and also the pillar that related to the education is society and knowledge. Under this pillar, they have committee on digital society and have one section called lifelong learning session. And this session, the aim, the objective of this session is to provide to utilize the digital technology to enabling the lifelong learning of the Thailand people. So under this section, under the policy of the government, all projects that provide the digital learning or digital education from every institute or every organization under the Ministry of Education or other ministry will combine together, will integration, have some kind of integration. This four major project is the project that have already established but share similar objective. So under the policy, we try to work together, try to collaborate and provide our MOOC education in the same platform. So it means that we can address all level of students and also the people in Thailand. You can see the name of the organization, Office of Basic Education, of Ministry of Education, Office of Permanent Education, take care of the non-formal education, and also Office of Higher Education. Okay, so we can cover more students. Okay, I put this logo to show to you that under the new Thai Mooc project, we have the cooperate effort from three ministries and three organizations that take care of maybe the major portion of the education level. the basic education, the office of permanent education, and the higher education, and also three major ministry support and put effort on this project. This is the conceptual model that how can we combine our project together and work together. We discussed about the conceptual model of the infrastructure. So we agreed to have some kind of the single account for all people. So you use only one account, you can continue your learning in this MOOC platform from your primary, secondary to your university, and after you graduate, working people, you can use the same account. The benefit of using the same account means that you can collect all your learning portfolio, that you do from your time of children until your working time, and your learning portfolio will support you in many, many ways. For example, it will show that you are very active learner, you are very curious or very good learner, and will prove as your performance if you can pass the exam of some courses, and also if you take the course from some university, maybe it will let you have opportunity to enter into that university or continuing your master degree or PhD in that university with exam for some courses, something like this. And so we have the central, we plan to have the central database, keep all content, keep all user account, and also the learning portfolio with all the major portal content. And we use the same platform that we adopt the Open EDX or Open EdX. We expect that in the future, when we're ready, we can do the credit transfer among one university to other university, also learning before enter the university, and also many, many applications using the learning portfolio, but not in the first phase. Maybe you should extend another 10 minutes for the time of click. Okay, this is the picture that we try to support all lifelong or level of student can utilize the Thai MOOC. Sorry, in Thai. Okay, this is the role of each ministry that we can we separate our role and take the responsible for the platform. The Ministry of ICT will provide the strong and reliable and scalable platform. For example, the cloud platform to the Thai MOOC, and also the Ministry of Science and Technology. They have a very very good organization called National Electronic and Computer Technology Center, NECTEC. That have very keen research about the computer technology and also the application development. This organization will participate and will be the major organization to adopt Open EdX and customize it to fit the feature that we design together. And also the Ministry of Education take care of the provide education to the learner. So in summarize, Thai MOOC will be the alternative education delivery model to support the lifelong learning of Thai people. And also, as the establishment or the project, we will learn research about the online education, the pedagogy, the assessment, the standard of MOOC way that very well established in other countries, but we will adopt to Thai context. we will do a lot of research about this in the first phase, and we confident that in the second phase we will more ready to do more application, for example, credit transfer or examination. And also, this is the way this project will strengthen our relationship among ministry, among institution, and also among all organization, including the university network. And also develop human resource. Okay, this is the model. So Thai Mooc, we provide the learning in many alternative way. For example, everyone can learn as their need, and they did not want to make any exam or take any credit, so they can learn and finish the learning as they prefer. But for the one that who want to record their success or their past, they can learn and take exam at the exam at the assessment service center. That they can after they pass, their record will collect in the credit bank, and then transfer, if possible, transfer to their home university or their host university. And also in the future, if they learn more courses, so they can collect all the courses and transfer to be maybe certificate or degree. As you may know that now some profession, for example, a nurse or teacher or pharmacist, they have to continue in their license with the continuing education. So we can use this MOOC way to provide the continuing education course to the profession, to those profession, that they can learn and they can get the credit, professional continuing education credit, and they can continue their license. In the first year, we try to, this is the major course I will show you later. This is the model. We also introduce the OER in interoperate with the MOOC course. OER is the object, open educational resources, maybe not in the size of the course, but smaller, but can more flexible to reuse. So we introduce the OER, including the MOOC and interoperate this together. For the OER side, all teacher can create or can share the OER, and also student can use the OER as their education benefit. But also some courses can utilize the OER as the material in the MOOC course also. But all the participants that participate in the system, they will have their portfolio. So this is a kind of mechanism to motivation or people to participate in. When one teacher contribute one resources, they have the record of their contribution. So they can show the contribution record to their principal or their boss to show their academic service activity. And if their contribution was rating, we have the rating system similar to Professor Jerry Merlo system. We adopt that kind of rating system. So if a lot of people rating that this is a good quality or quality content, then they have some kind of credential to show to their principal. Similar to the MOOC course, we try to introduce this portfolio for learner and for the teacher. Okay, I think the time is up. So now, up until now, under this project, we have we have worked with 9 region university, meaning the whole country university, and they propose courses to be the first phase MOOC courses in the Thai MOOC, and now we collect more than 125 courses that will be finished and can be provided the beginning of next year, totally cover 1,400 hours of learning. And I have some name of course story in Thai, but you can recognize if you can read Thai. You can recognize that this is a small courses, but very benefit or very, very useful for daily life or to develop, or is very up to date or very address the way of living. Maybe some courses very unique from some area. For example, batik is the way to produce the batik. Close, and also communication in English, communication in Malayu, benefit from the southern part people, something like this. And also many small courses benefit to the teacher, to the student, and to the people. Some you do it yourself courses also appear in the first phase courses. So in the first phase, we would like to experiment or try to provide the courses. And then we will learn more. And then after that, we ready for the second page. That will be the whole course, the full courses, and more application, for example, credit transfer. Thank you very much. Sorry for use more time, but you have to extend more for my lap time of clicker. Thank you very much.
Since we are behind the schedule, actually, Dr. Anuchit, you still have like a few minutes. If those who are interested to ask some questions about Thai Mooc, you are free to do so. Okay, if not,